For these, it's just important to remember this has sloped stone wall, right? And when you look at this, this looks like it has, well, this shape. This is the outer edge. If you're actually looking at it now, it's on the other side, right? I mean, that's not just me. That's right, it's me, Scryptar. How are you doing, folks? I'm doing great. We're back with another episode of ARK Survival Evolved. I've added another mod to this game, which is the ARK Fog Remover. Just came out yesterday, and as far as I can tell, it's working, because when I logged out, standing here, it was foggy all around, and I just added that mod, logged back in, and it's gone. So, we're gonna do some stuff today. I prepared a little montage to show you why these are all fired up, which I'm going to show you in a second here. Once that's done, we're going to craft up some more stuff and we go back down there and start working on the base. So enjoy the montage! Thank you. Did you like that? Tell me you like that. Tell me! I like that! I like that very much. So, montage done. We've been gathering up a heck of resources. I mean, this is still running. Fire should go out very soon. This is like the third fill, I believe. The montage didn't capture everything I was doing. It's, I don't know, 25% maybe? Here you go, that's what we have. Crafted up all the polymer we need. I believe we have enough crystal and metal to do all the stuff we have to do. Which is... this guy and 7 more of these. Shall we try? Well, give me those 5 and then see what's left. Let's see what we're missing. Pretty sure it's metal. Which we have. Right here. Yep. There you go. And I should be able to carry that, right? Yeah, pretty much. Stay here, and as always, follow this guy, you too. Just to make sure if we get attacked, they don't fly away, they come back. And I've been attacked quite frequently here, so we need to do something about that, for which we need to get all of that done. For all the other resources, guess what? Yeah, we are prepared. I made some more ceilings, I made some walls. Slope walls. I didn't do the sloped ceilings yet, just the walls for them, but I believe we have enough resources here, and pretty sure, yeah, over here to craft up some more. We might need some fiber, which we have upstairs, so we're gonna do that. I'd say let's start placing those walls, right? Best thing to do now, because once they are done, we can start working on the superstructure for real. Joe. Let's do this. This straight. More or less. Which way are you moving? A little bit towards us, so it's just a smidge to the left. That was way too much. Let's try that. Nope. Really? Let's try it on here. Well, you can already see it's a little bit to the left. Looks good. As long as you don't move the mouse, you can even use the ceiling upstairs to see if it's good or not. Well, that should be not perfect, but good enough for us. So, we're gonna do it as we did this one. It's every other foundation. So, standing here in the middle, we did this. And then we leave this one free, of course, because this won't work. And this one will be the next one. Zoom in a little bit so we can see how much we are to the left and right. Looks good to me. A little bit towards us, maybe. Rather not do that. That's good. More. Why is this not working? Who's in the way? Oh, that ceiling on top there is in the way. If I... what? Shouldn't be. Yeah, have fun. If I remove that ceiling, this will all come crashing down. No, it won't. Just the front part. I can live with the front part. Just have to get out of K mode. So much I can do about that, right? Okay. Necessary interruptions. You gained a level from that. I'm so proud of you. So, just to get rid of the corpse, otherwise the next Archie will aggro on that. Don't want that. Are we done? Finally. So we will have the same problem here. But it's what, 4 ceilings? We can live with that. One other good thing, you can jump down here as you've just seen without hurting yourself. So if you run up here, like, miss the spot, yeah, doesn't hurt. Just about not, which is nice. Good, so, where were we? Trying to build a base here. Don't need to be overly perfect for this one, because it's the last one. If it's just inclined a little to the left or right, you won't really notice anyway. So, as we're not moving left to right, and might move them back or forth by doing so, done. I could have used regular storage and just put them back to back. I mean, this is, what, 150 spaces? Regular storage, it was 30 some time ago, it's now 45. So 3 of that would pretty much equal this, and in this space you can fit 5. That's more than you can fit in here. It's just 50,000? 2,400. This can be destroyed by pretty much anything. This cannot. So this is our main storage for all the big stuff we need. And also, if we do this right, when this is full, we should have enough material to do whatever we like, and we just need to keep it filled. So whenever we want to have something, there's only one vault for each material that we need to check, and then we know how much we have, and that's it. If we have like 5 to 10 storage boxes here, then it's like you could have metal in this one, and the next one will be empty, and then you have some in here, and then you took some out of that one. This is efficient. That's what we're going to do. So, same over here. Get back to the building. No. Possibly. So I'm going to line it up with that little part that I'm standing on right now, with this edge. Because this is an edge you find on every ceiling. And now if I move... See, I'm moving that way, so we need to go a little bit to the right. Just a little bit. Come on, move. That's too much. Let's see. Oh, that's actually perfect. Well, as close to perfect as we're gonna get it. So, this ceiling. Yes, this ceiling is the right one. I'm going to line it up so that it is on top of that edge, because that belongs to that ceiling over there. If we color that in a different color than the one here, we're going to have this weird smudge of color looking through. Yeah, I like that. You have pretty much the same texture on the ceiling, so we get the same result there. Makes sense to do it this way. So, that's that one. Link it up. That one. That one. And the last one. Done. Nice. Not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. So the platform is done. You. Stop that. You're annoying. So you can put the quads in here, which means if the quads fit, the Bronto would fit as well. Yeah. Just land. Thank you. And put on some weight. Take that. I'm gonna take that. Keep the rest in there for now. You can have all of this. I need that. Thank you. Let me down. That's one of the good things for spacing them evenly. You can walk through here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna park our main harvesting dinosaurs like right along here and on the other side. So one side will be our rides, which is our T-Rex, maybe a Spino, and whatever we want to have, and the other side will be all harvesting. And these will be the vaults for mainly harvesting. For example, this should be wood, thatch, and fiber, if I remember correctly. We're gonna name them in a moment. For this moment, though, we're gonna take all of these. Take all of these. Thank you. I like it when the game does what I wanted to do. And we're gonna repair this. What we're also gonna do is put in the second row here as much as we can. And we're gonna get some more ceilings. Go! And hatch frames. So how many can I carry? Oh, barely. It's fine. I've been pumping weight again. As you full well noticed, I guess. I put you in here. We should get lighter with every step. So this will be our office area. This will be our building. We're gonna go in two more from here, because this will be a walkway up, and as the walls are too high, and we're gonna use a sloped roof for this rather than this steep ramp, a sloped roof goes up one wall in a space, one ceiling or foundation long, pretty much it. So this will be one up, and this will get us two up. So right here will be a wall. From here on out, this three wide and whatever long it is, like eight, seven, eight long, will be our main work area. Same on the other side. There you go. And that's it for the base of the superstructure. That's what it's gonna be. It's pretty big. I mean, we can fit a lot of stuff in here. So, let me get some of the walls and some other stuff, and I will finish a little bit of the outsides of this, and then I meet you right back. So, back. This is what it looks like for now. Getting there. Let's have a look and see how we do this and what we're going to do with this. So first of all, of course, we have our access to the inventories of the vaults here, which we're going to name in a second, don't worry. Then we have walls on the outside, too high, and we have our walkway up here. This is going to be the roof. This is where we're going to park our flyers. So we will put up some fences around here, and technically I've already done it wrong, because you can't put a fence here. This sloped roof will obstruct that. If you put the fence first and then put the roof on, that would actually work. For this roof to be in here, we needed to have this slope wall on the side, one there and one up there, as you can see. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go over to the other side and just reproduce that so you can see how I did this. There will be a fence here and a fence here and here, so we don't fall off. So first of all, let's put some walls. One here. Make sure that you put it on the right side, otherwise you mess up everything. Like if we put the door there. Why do we put a door here? This is going to be a little secret room under the stairs. That's our Harry Potter room. Already have one out here. In here, I will put a beer barrel or something like that. Yeah, why not? I mean, we need to put it somewhere and it's not really of use, so if you want to have it in the game because you can, then put it there. It doesn't hurt anyone. So, let's just start with the easy stuff. We put up some walls. I've put up the ceilings up there already and I left some open holes, as you can see. Wherever these access holes are, I want to have a window going out there. Same here. And if I place the ceiling first, then the wall which I'm going to place on top of that window might snap to the ceiling instead of the actual window frame. And sometimes that gives us a little glitchy look, and I don't like that. So then, from here on out, this will be interior. So this way, please. Except for the first three. 1, 2, 3. Because all of this, we're gonna have a glass roof. And I just want to make sure I don't forget about that, so I stop right here. We don't really need the roof at the moment anyway. It's PvE, nothing's gonna come and kill us, well, at least not a player. So no need to worry about that. The roof is really just there for completeness at the moment. That means we have to leave this open. I'm probably not gonna have glass on the sides, just on top. So we could put the walls already. I'm not 100% sure yet. So, this has to be left open, because once we put down the forge, we can't place a wall here anymore. That one works, this one doesn't. Don't ask, it's ARK. and this will be our access to the forge from up here, so we want to have that open. The forge is blocking the access, so nothing can fall in from the top or creep in from the bottom. This will be closed, it will just not have a wall. So, let's get outside here. Need one more wall there, and then on top of that, we need these. For these, it's just important to remember this has sloped stone wall, right? And when you look at this, this looks like it has, well, this shape. This is the outer edge. If you're actually looking at it now, it's on the other side, right? I mean, that's not just me. If I were to place this here, that way around, so that the wood is on the inside, if you compare that to my number one slot, it's completely the other way around. That's for all of those engrams. So if you just keep that in mind, that you're basically, when you look at the engram, you're looking at the inside, not the outside, although there are no wooden supports to indicate that this is actually the inside you're looking at, then you should be fine. That, and now we should be able to place not that, that. It's important when you do this, place that wall first, because once you've put this in, you can't place that wall anymore. It's obstructed. ARK. Same here. If you haven't placed that wall, you can't place it afterwards. There you go. That's a smooth, nice walkway up to the top. Let's put a ceiling here. That works very well. So this is how I built this part. All the rest is just ceilings on top. I mean, you can do that, right? No issue there. So, I'm gonna continue finishing all of this part, except for the first, you know, three that we just talked about. Off camera, because it's just placing some windows and placing some ceilings. Not really anything important to look at. For now, I'm gonna name those walls. So right on top there, I would like to have the first crafting station, which is the smithy. Rename wall. This is wood, thatch, fiber. Which basically gives me 50 slots of each. That should be more than enough. Wood, thatch, fiber should be right. Then the next one. Now I just have to have a quick look, give me a second. This one will be height, pelt. Actually, I made a slight mistake there. This is height, pelt or fur or whatever you want to call it, and fiber. And this one over here is wood, thatch, and stone, because this is exactly what you need to craft all the stuff we've been crafting, right? The stone, wood, and thatch. So, makes sense to group those together. This is the next group, because hide, pelt, and fiber, well, the smithy does armor, so you need the pelt close by. And the hide for repairing bows and crossbows and all of that stuff. Then pretty much everything needs hide there. And fiber, you always need fiber. I mean, even the metal armor we're wearing needs fiber, so yes, want that. This one is gonna be chitin and keratin. And this one is gonna be flint and obsidian, which we don't need that off. Over here, this is the most important one. This is metal. In every form or shape. We can stand here, access that inventory from quite afar, like here, and right there on that ceiling, that's where our forge is going to be. So you can transfer back and forth the ore and the finished material. And then once you've done that, you can go upstairs. And right here will be the fabricator, and you can go here, get all the stuff, turn around, put it in, that's it. That's how we're gonna work. This one is all the pastes and powders. So that's going to be cementing paste, gunpowder, spark powder. What else do we have? Yeah, all of those. For charcoal, I have an extra locker upstairs. What's the next resource? Next resource is pearls, crystal, and oil. Not gasoline. Gasoline is a finished product. It's gonna be upstairs. And the last one, it's pretty much random stuff. I like to use this one for fertilizer. Can do whatever you like in this one, don't really care. The others all make sense. This is just pretty random because it's symmetrical, but fertilizer seems to be a good thing there. If you have a defense around your outer walls with plant species X, you need a lot of fertilizer, so it makes sense to have a dedicated storage for that, which you can access from the inside, where we actually will produce our fertilizer, and from the outside, where we will take it out to deliver it to all of our plants. So, that's all that done, right? Yeah, that's that done. And I'm pretty sure that's it for this episode, including the montage and everything. We should have a good half an hour done. So, next time I'm going to show you the finished product as far as we can go, and then we're going to put up some glass, maybe. Otherwise, we need to go out and hunt for some more creatures. We need two little bugs to produce fertilizer for us. So, we're going to go and find us a nice little cave and find us some nice little bugs. Looking forward to that one. That's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more. Leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. See you soon.